I'm here at the Princeton Club of New York City for a private luncheon event with the main speaker, Professor Timothy Tong. He's also the president of Hong Kong Polytechnic University. Today, we're going to hear more about Hong Kong's technology, science, and higher education.
Give me a chance to share some thoughts with you about education in Hong Kong, as well as perhaps technology development in Hong Kong.
Timothy Tong kicks off his speech by announcing Hong Kong Polytechnic University's compliance with government-funded university's new move of going from a three-year bachelor degree program to a four-year system. In order to deliver the best education possible, they decided to use the extra year to focus on fulfilling service skills for the community.
We have actually instituted a new requirement for all of our students. That is, they all have to fulfill a service learning subject before graduation. But the reason we are so committed in doing it is that we believe that by connecting our students' learning in a professional discipline to what community actually needs, we would end up preparing a better person for society.
Facing the trend of universities' internationalization, Tong said his school is helping their students to know their role in a global perspective.
We are not just talking about how many international students we have on campus or how many foreign-born professors we have recruited, but we are taking it one step further by looking at, from a content point of view, what we are doing that can actually incorporate an international element.
Tong stressed out technology and science is playing an increasingly important role in Hong Kong's economic growth and global competitiveness. To foster research and development, the government offers financial incentive in the form of cash rebate.
Hong Kong also 3 years ago started a program by giving cash rebate to industries that fund research projects at universities. You can see in 3 years the program, what has resulted, over 800 applications to this program so far.
Those who attended the luncheon shared their enthusiasm for bridging the gap between research and application.
Universities play a huge role in how young people can be well educated and can really further commercialization and invention. And so it was very exciting to learn about some of the things, some of the ways people in Hong Kong are thinking about that in the government as well as universities.
The distance between innovation and application is getting closer, and the universities are smack in the middle. They are no longer ivory towers.
Technology convergence with creative industry, for instance, is what makes New York so much more attractive. We have a lot to learn from others, but so is the other way around.
For more information from Sinovision English Channel, you can find us online at en.sinovision.net. Reporting for Sinovision Journal, I'm Jane Stone.